Aloha and welcome back to my channel, guys. My name is Ella and I help you retrain your brain. If you don't know anything about me yet, back in 2008, I had an AVM rupture in my cerebellum, which led to a stroke. After that, there was a long road of mental rehab and I finally learned how to transition my rock bottom into my breakthrough. Now I post videos every other week to help you make the same transition. So if you don't want to miss upcoming content, make sure you subscribe using the button below. It is September, which means it's Brain Aneurysm Awareness Month, and October next month is going to be AVM Awareness Month. Since I had an AVM rupture, I decided I would do two videos dedicated to those awareness months. This video is going to be a message for youth brain injury survivors, and next video is going to be a message for parents of youth brain injury survivors. So again, if you don't want to miss that video, subscribe using the button below and you can tap the bell to receive notification when I upload it. I'm gonna start this video by giving a bit of information on what happened to me after I had my brain injury, and then I'm going to go into three main points I want to address. About 13 and a half years ago, I had something called an AVM rupture in my cerebellum. And what an AVM is basically arteries and veins that are supposed to come together via tiny little blood vessels called capillaries. They did not form correctly, and we had no idea. I had no idea. They formed into this big clump of blood vessels, which is called a nidus. And if you can imagine how a balloon gets bigger and bigger when more air gets blown into it, just like a balloon, the nidus kept getting bigger and bigger and bigger as more blood flowed through. And then one day, January 2008, when I was just 14 years old, that nidus popped. So the stroke affected the left side of my cerebellum as well as the right side of my cortex. And that led to weakness of my entire left side. I'm very lucky now that I am able to use my left side with very, very minor weakness. But at the time, I wasn't a walker. I did have to go to speech pathology, OT, PT, the very standard rehab process. And I will say my physical rehab and the healthcare I've received was fantastic. And I'm so lucky and I'm so grateful. The only thing that was not a standard part of my rehab, which is why I do the advocacy work I do now, was the mental and emotional and cognitive component. I was very lucky as a young, healthy athlete to be able to physically rehabilitate, but nobody ever informed me that I would experience cognitive, mental, and emotional changes afterwards. And so as these changes were happening, I just thought I was becoming a crazy person, and it led to a lot of depression and suicidal thoughts. Eventually, 10 years after my stroke, I finally hit my breaking point and I started talking to somebody about all these thoughts I had been repressing. And sure enough, it turns out that a lot of these things I've been noticing about myself post-stroke could have been actually due to my stroke. So if you are a youth brain injury survivor watching this, I don't want you to have to wait and struggle for 10 years like I did. I want you to start helping yourself right now. And there's three ways that you can start doing that. Number one is I want you to be brave enough to have a conversation about all the thoughts that you're going on inside of your head. Don't repress anything. That was the biggest mistake that I made. There are so many outlets and anonymous helplines and apps where you can get help for free. And really, I want you to take advantage of that. Sometimes it's easier to talk to somebody that you don't know because there's no fear of judgment. And I know I had a really big fear that I would always be judged by somebody when I said I felt different. And if you're a youth, anything like me, you might just be stubborn and not want to talk to your parents because, like me, I thought I was too cool for school. And yeah, I just wasn't comfortable talking to my parents and letting them know that I was really sad. So if you're not comfortable having these types of conversations with your parents or your siblings or somebody in your family, I'm going to leave a directory or whatever I can find of anonymous helplines that you can reach out to and get some help for free. I'm also going to leave a couple other resources in the description box. One is for the Aneurysm and AVM Foundation. They have a great youth program that I hope you check out. And the other resource I'll leave in the description is for a platform called Youpopolis. They are exclusively a platform for youth to meet other people in their community and not go through the challenges post-injury or disease or illness, whatever you have or are going through, to not go through those things alone. If you are repressing negative thoughts, one thing I want you to remember is that nobody can read your mind. When I was growing up repressing all these negative thoughts, I just wanted somebody to be able to read my mind and understand what I was going through without me having to say it. Because I didn't want to hurt my pride, I didn't want to look weak, and I just kept everything inside. But if you share what's going on inside your head, that is not a point of weakness, that is a point of strength. Because you're able to put yourself in a position that feels vulnerable in order to actually get help. That is a sign of bravery and that is a sign of strength. So please try to just do yourself the favor and find somebody that you are comfortable speaking with, and remember, nobody can read your mind. You have to be the one to initiate the conversation and say what is going on in your head. And if you have no idea how to start these conversations or who to talk to, you can honestly please send me an email. If you're on Instagram, send me a message on Instagram. Facebook, send me a message on Facebook. I'm going to leave all the links below and I can help you come up with something to say so that you can initiate this conversation. Hi friend, whoever that might be, I really need to talk about something that I've been repressing for a while. It's making me upset and I know I need to talk to somebody about it. I'm not looking for advice right now. I just need somebody to listen. Are you okay with doing that for me? Because you started with that message, now the person you are going to confide in is also probably going to feel more comfortable because now they know they don't need to give you any advice, they don't need to worry about saying the right or wrong thing, they just need to listen. The second message I have for youth brain injury survivors is not to devalue the changes and feelings that you feel. One thing that I always did growing up was look at other people who were less fortunate than I was when it came to injury or disability or illness or disease and think, well, I'm pretty lucky compared to those people. And that was very true. However, that doesn't mean that my feelings aren't valid. So you can feel lucky compared to other people. I'm very lucky compared to a lot of other people who have had brain injuries. But that doesn't mean the sadness and the changes that I feel inside aren't valid and they need to be addressed. What I always like to say to get this message across is it doesn't matter how much or how little different you are compared to other people. What matters is you feel different. End of sentence. Matters if you feel different than you did pre-stroke or pre-brain injury, pre-TBI, whatever type of injury you had. That is the only thing that matters. Yes, it is important to be empathetic to other people who have experienced things that you did not experience. However, that does not mean you should be completely dismissing your feelings. Now, the third message I have for youth brain injury survivors is do not impose limitations on yourself. With science and technology nowadays, there are so many different ways that we can retrain our brains. My recommendation is to expect that you're going to have challenges now. Actually, I want you to identify what things you have challenges with. It can be general or specific. And keep adding to that list as you notice more difficulties. Once you've identified those things, start working on ways that you can improve or you can at least try to adapt or compensate. I don't like the words "I can't," although I understand that some people might feel that they can't do certain things. That can totally be the case with some disabilities. But what I will encourage for you is to, instead of say, "I can't," say something like, "I have a hard time with," whatever it is, and then think of a way you can adapt or compensate to achieve that thing. For example, I have a really hard time coordinating my thoughts, saying things so they make coherent sense. And so instead of saying something like, "I cannot write an essay because it's hard for me to coordinate my thoughts," I say things like, "It's going to take me a long time to figure out how to write this essay compared to other people. I need to take the extra time to get that done." So that means starting early, not procrastinating on tasks, doing things that put me at an advantage. Please try to not always default to your brain injury as an excuse for not trying things, or at least not trying to adapt to new things. Because as soon as you start always defaulting to your brain injury as an excuse, you're never going to be able to get out of that pattern, or at least it's going to be very hard. For example, if you have memory challenges, try not to say, "Oh, I had a brain injury, so I'm always forgetting." Or if you're having coordination issues like me and you're writing something, try not to say, "Oh, I had a brain injury, so I know I'm not going to be able to do this." Replace "I can't" with "I am going to challenge myself and figure out a way." If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up below. It really helps my content reach more people. And please share this video with a fellow youth brain injury survivor that you might know. As always, I hope you guys have a great day, and don't forget to make this the year of you. Bye.